Hello students, welcome to the class. And in this class I will be dealing with the Iran and US relationship, and the specific thing that I will be dealing with in this class is about why Donald Trump wants to revoke the nuclear agreement with Iran that got the sanction of the European powers and United States of America in the month of July 2015, and why Donald Trump wants to revoke this agreement. Now, before we understand the reason, before we understand basically the intention of Donald Trump in revoking this, we need to understand the history of relationship between Iran and United States of America. Now, both these countries, they had been friends till 1979. Now, what happened in 1979 that made these friends to become adversaries of each other? What unfolded in 1979? So 1979 was a period of Iranian revolution. Now, when Iranian revolution unfolded, it resulted in doing away with a regime that was ruling Iran, and that regime had a friendly relationship with the United States of America. So after 1979, the relationship between USA and America, it had entered a phase of confrontation and antagonism. Now, why this confrontation and antagonism? Itna ladai jhagda dono desho ke beech mein kyun ho gaya? Now, after 1979, Iran had adopted a kind of a governmental system that was having a lot of influence of religion in the functioning of the state. But when it comes to United States of America, it had always believed that the functioning of the economy should be conducted by removing the denominator of religion. United States of America had always wanted Iran to side with its capitalistic agenda. But once this Iranian revolution had unfolded, Iran actually had tried to tryst with the forces with which USA was not comfortable with. Now, what were these forces? The first and the foremost force that the United States of America was not comfortable was the force of socialism and communism. Iran had got bit cozy with communism and socialism. And secondly, Iran had got cozy with Shia agenda of diplomacy. Now, what is this Shia agenda of diplomacy? Now, when we have a look at the entire Middle East countries and the equation between these countries, there is an equation between the Shia and the Sunni countries. Now, Sunni countries are represented by Saudi Arabia, and Shia countries are represented by Iran. Now, both these countries, they are the pioneer countries of the Shias, Shiaism and Sunniism. Now, because United States of America had to be friendly with, had to establish friendly relationship with Saudi Arabia, it got into more adversarial situation with Iran. So this is the history about this entire United States of America and Iran relationship. Now, when after Iran's revolution of 1979, Iran had challenged the discriminatory nuclear regime that was established by the non-proliferation treaty and by institutionalizing nuclear suppliers group. Now, Iran was actually against this discriminatory regime, and because Iran was actually challenging United States of America, it had wanted to protect itself. And now, how could Iran protect itself? Iran could have protected itself if it would have an access to the nuclear weaponry. So Iran began to develop this nuclear weaponry after 1979. So it took Iran about 3 to 4 decades to establish this nuclear paraphernalia. Now, after establishing nuclear paraphernalia, United States of America and European powers, they had imposed political sanctions, economic sanctions and social sanctions on Iran. And it took about a decade for this negotiation process to yield some result, and ultimately the result was yielded in 2015, the month of July. Now, after this month, Iran had agreed after negotiations that it will be putting its all nuclear paraphernalia under the surveillance of International Atomic Energy Agencies, and it will be doing whatever is expected out of it, out of Iran as a country, by the European countries and by America. It is not going to come out and substantiate its nuclear program. So Iran is fulfilling all the demands that were reached out as per this agreement of July 2015. But of late, now what is happening? Of late, Donald Trump is actually against this treaty that was signed by Barack Obama. Now, why Donald Trump is against this treaty? Now, according to Donald Trump, this treaty is not serving the interests of United States of America. Reason number one, Iran still is supporting Hezbollah. That is the terrorist outfit present in Lebanon. And this terrorist outfit, that is Hezbollah, is also helping the terrorist outfits who are fighting against ISIS. So Iran's position with respect to ISIS is also not very clear. And secondly, Iran is also supporting the Houthi terrorists who are operating in Yemen. Iran is also testing ballistic missiles. Now, these actions of Iran's are some of the actions that are actually antagonizing United States of America. Now, United States of America wants actually Iran to withdraw or to do away with the support to the terrorist groups like Hezbollah, Houthi, and not to test these ballistic missiles. Now, America also wanted that the fight between the Shia and the Sunni should not be intensified, because it's the Sunni partners, they are not feeling comfortable with the rise in the strength of Iran. And moreover, Iran is openly challenging Israel. Now, Israel has been one of the staunch allies of United States of America. Now, all these things are antagonizing Donald Trump. And this is one of the reasons that he just wants to revoke the nuclear agreement that has been reached between Iran and United States of America. Now, it is coming out for ratification in the month of October. 15th October, there will be the ratification that will be pending for to sign between America and Iran. Now, on October 15th, they will be basically deciding about whether America will basically be deciding about, American president basically will be deciding about whether Iran is toying to the negotiation treaty that was reached in the month of July 2015 or not. And as far as IAEA is concerned, International Atomic Energy Agency is concerned, it has already said that Iran is actually accepting all the demands as per this agreement of July 2015. So whatever Donald Trump is going to do with respect to this agreement, it will be not because Iran is not respecting the terms of the agreement. It will be because out of its misery that Iran is supporting these terrorist outfits, and these actions of Iran don't fall well with respect to the diplomatic equation that United States of America actually wants to have. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can order video class packages at BrainyIAS.com. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.